What's your go-to calendar app? The one that keeps your schedule from turning into total chaos? For a lot of people, it comes down to two main options, Google Calendar and Apple Calendar. Both are popular, both are reliable, and both are designed to help you manage everything from daily tasks to long-term projects. But if you had to choose just one, how would you know which is actually the better fit for your lifestyle and work style? I'm Noel with Jotform. And in this video, we're going to explore exactly how Google Calendar and Apple Calendar compare. We'll look at their key features, what makes each one unique, and the situations where one might work better than the other. Let's jump right in. We all know how busy life can get with meetings, appointments, travel, time off, and the constant juggling of work and personal commitments. It's no wonder so many of us rely on digital calendar tools to keep it all straight. And in the world of scheduling platforms, the debate between Google Calendar and Apple Calendar is one of the most common. The truth is, the right choice often comes down to your personal preferences, the devices you use, and how you like to manage your time. So let's start with a quick side-by-side snapshot of what each one offers. Apple Calendar gives you iCloud syncing, intelligent event suggestions, and location-based travel time estimates. It's built right into iOS, macOS, iPadOS, and watchOS, so it's native to the Apple ecosystem. You can share it with other iCloud users, adjust your view, and customize notifications, colors, and display styles. Google Calendar offers multiple shared calendars, the ability to set up event rooms and appointment scheduling, customizable availability, time insights, a variety of customization options, and plenty of integrations. It's supported on a wide range of operating systems and browsers. In terms of collaboration, it allows you to share events, set up group calendars, and view multiple calendars at once. It also offers highly flexible customization of notifications, layouts, colors, and working hours. So let's break these down individually, starting with Google Calendar. For anyone who's not an Apple-only user, Google Calendar is often the top choice. In fact, plenty of Apple users prefer it over Apple's own calendar app. One of its biggest strengths is cross-platform compatibility. With both a mobile app and a browser version, it works on iOS, Android, and just about any device with internet access. That means you're never locked into one ecosystem. Its collaborative capabilities are also a big draw. Google Calendar makes it easy to keep a whole team on the same page. You can create shared events, let others view your calendar in real time, and even overlay multiple calendars at once to find the best meeting times. It's a huge advantage for coordinating across departments or managing multiple projects. Integration is another area where Google Calendar shines. As part of the Google Workspace suite, it seamlessly connects with Gmail, Google Meet, Google Tasks, and more. On top of that, it works with many third-party apps, including Jotform's Google Calendar integration. This integration can automatically create calendar events based on form submissions. This is a great way to skip manual entry, reduce errors, and keep your schedule up to date. You can even map form fields like event title, date, and time so everything appears exactly how you want it. Then there are the advanced features. Google Calendar lets you block out focus time so you can work uninterrupted. Set up specific appointment slots for clients or colleagues, establish preset office hours, and use the Find a Time tool to quickly identify open slots for everyone involved. You can get daily agenda emails to keep your priorities top of mind, and you can use the Speedy Meetings option to shave a few minutes off meeting lengths, which adds up over time. Because it's tied into Google Workspace, you also get helpful automation like event suggestions pulled directly from your Gmail. And with AI tools like Google Gemini, you can get even more streamlined scheduling and editing support. Customization is another strong point. You can set your calendar to a daily, weekly, monthly, or agenda view, color code events for easy reference, and set up notifications that fit your work style. If you want uninterrupted work time, you can mute notifications during focus periods or outside your working hours. Security is also a priority for Google. Your calendar is protected by two-factor authentication, robust encryption, and strict sharing controls, so you can decide exactly who can see your events. Now, let's turn to Apple Calendar. While it's exclusive to Apple devices, that's not necessarily a drawback when you consider how many people already use iPhones, iPads, Macs, and Apple Watches. For those in the Apple ecosystem, Apple Calendar offers a seamless, native experience. Everything syncs automatically across your devices, so if you add an event on your Mac, it shows up instantly on your phone and watch. It also integrates neatly with other Apple apps. For example, the Mail app can suggest events directly from email messages, so you can add them to your calendar without manually typing in the details. One of Apple Calendar's biggest selling points is its clean, minimalist design. It's intuitive and easy to navigate, which is great if you're not looking for a ton of extra features. This simplicity makes it accessible to everyone, even people who aren't particularly tech-savvy. Siri integration adds another layer of convenience. You can ask Siri to create events, check your schedule, or tell you when to leave for a meeting based on real-time traffic via Apple Maps. Siri can also pull event suggestions from your messages and emails to speed up scheduling. Apple Calendar also supports iCloud sharing, which is perfect for families or small teams who all use Apple devices. You can securely share calendars within your iCloud network so everyone stays on the same page. One area where Apple Calendar has an edge is offline access. While Google Calendar can work offline, you have to enable the setting manually. With Apple Calendar, offline access is always available by default. That means you can check or edit your calendar anytime, even without the internet. In terms of customization, Apple Calendar keeps it straightforward. You can change colors, adjust your display, and tweak other basic elements enough to personalize it without overwhelming you with too many settings. So which one's the better fit? Both Google Calendar and Apple Calendar offer automated event creation, customizable reminders, and sharing capabilities. But if collaboration and integrations are priorities, Google Calendar has the advantage. To make your decision, think about your devices, how much you collaborate with others, and whether integrations and automation are a must-have for you. If you're already deep in the Apple ecosystem and prefer a clean, easy-to-use interface, Apple Calendar is a solid choice. If you want cross-platform access, advanced features, and a high level of customization, Google Calendar might be your best bet. And remember, with Jotform's Google Calendar integration, you can take your scheduling to the next level by automating the entire process. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Noel with Jotform, and I hope this walkthrough helps you choose the calendar that's going to make your life a whole lot easier. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss our next video. See you soon.